life's a paper to flake. From the cradle to grave.
And you guys did a video for Life's a Song, speaking of that song. In the beginning, you guys are sitting around looking at old pictures. Tell us a little bit about the video.
Yeah, you know, the song, it just, that particular song to me sounded the most like, you know, classic Warrant from, you know, could have been on Cherry Pie or Dirty Rotten Filthy Stinking Rich, and we haven't put out a song like that since then, you know, really. It's been a long time, so it seemed like a great opportunity to do something that sounded like old school Warrant. And then the concept for the video, I believe Jerry came up with it, you know, just having like a scrapbook and looking through all the different memories of our rock and roll Warrant life, and turned out pretty good.
Yeah, it did. It's a really good video.
Ah, thank you.
Yeah, definitely. Now, who did the cover art for the album?
Glenn Mason, and you'll notice that our singer's name is Robert Mason.
Uh-huh.
And there is a relation.
Okay.
It's Robert's brother, little brother. He did a really good job. I mean, the cover's cool, you know, mm-hmm. but really where the whole, for me, where it all pays off is the insert, you know, when you see all the therapist notes for each song, and it's about this guy who's a rockaholic and he's going to see his, therapist and trying to, you know, solve his addiction, and then there's all these crazy pictures of us in there, and it turned out really, really, really cool. Robert and Jerry came up with the concept, and I pushed real hard for the Rockaholic as the title. Originally, I think it was a song title I heard Jerry mention, and I'm like, oh man, that's got to be the record title. And
absolutely.
And there was some other titles going around, a lot of discussions, and we're going back and forth. And I think one of the other titles we were thinking about was Angels and Outlaws, or Outlaws and Angels. I'm not sure, one of the two. Maybe another title or so, and I just kept saying Rockaholic, Rockaholic, Rockaholic. And then when Jerry and Robert came up with the concept for the CD booklet, it all, and then we all agreed. We just thought, yeah, it's a great concept. It's a title. It all ties together, and that's what we did.
Yeah, definitely. It all fits together perfect. Now,
yeah,
as opposed to 20 years ago, you have things today like MySpace and Facebook and just a ton of networking sites. What do you think of the social media stuff going on today? Does it make it harder, easier for bands? What do you think?
It's really cool, and it's a lot of work to keep up with all of it.
It is a lot of work.
You know, I do most of the Twitter stuff. Some of the other guys chime in once in a while, and I'm sure they'll do more. And Facebook, we all kind of work on together, and you know, everybody has more time for this or that or more interest in different things, but yeah, we're trying to utilize, you know, of course we have our website, warrantrocks.com, and if you go there, you'll find links to Twitter and Facebook, and we got a new Warrant app coming out, so you'll be able to download that onto your iPhone or iPad or iTouch.
Awesome.
Or all that good stuff in the next week. We're still putting stuff on there, so when you download it, there'll be something to look at. It's brand new, so we'll have that we need to update, and then, of course, Twitter and Facebook, we do that daily. And I think it helps. I think it's cool. I think it's great to have that direct connection with individual connection with your fans, you know.
Definitely. Now, I had no idea you guys had a wine out. Tell us about that.
Yeah, Warrant Red. If you drink it, it'll make you smarter and better looking.
I like that.
So, yeah, and you feel good, too. Some friends of mine, actually these promoters, they started a website called artistwine.com, and we're the first artists. And so I tried out a bunch of different wines at Greg's house, and I ended up selecting this winery up in Napa called Christian Story Wines. So he introduced me to Christian, the winemaker and owner, and we hit it off. And he started sending me all these different blends and seeing what I liked about this one and what I liked about that one. And, you know, at the end of the day, we ended up with it's a red. It's mostly, you know, Cabernet, Merlot, Zinfandel, with just like 5% Petit Verdot. And it's 2007. It's actually really good. And you can check it out. You can go to our website, warrantrocks.com, if you're interested in getting any. We can't sell alcohol. We don't have a license to do that. But when you click on the wine bottle, it'll take you to Christian Story's website where you can buy it online if you're 21 or older.
Very cool. Very cool. Now, you guys have shows listed on your website right now through October, so I know you guys are going to add more. Everybody can just keep an eye on warrantrocks.com and check and see when you guys are going to be in their town, right?
Yeah, absolutely. We last weekend we were in Columbia, Maryland at the M3 Festival, which was great. And then this Saturday we're playing with Whitesnake at the Coushatta Casino and Resort in Tender, Louisiana.
Awesome.
And then we're playing with Poison. We have 5 shows coming up with Poison in Tupelo, Missouri, El Paso, Texas, Monterey, Mexico, South Haven, Mississippi. We got another show in Birmingham, Alabama. Those are all with Poison. And then we're also playing with Whitesnake in Wichita, Kansas. And it goes on and on. Right now I'm looking at our schedule. It goes through. We just booked 2 shows at Cactus Pete's Casino in Jackpot, Nevada for 2 nights in December, Friday 9th and 10th, which will be cool. And we're going to the UK for 1 show so far in October, and then we got a lot of other stuff pending that's not on the, a lot of stuff that's pending that's not on the website. We just accepted an offer to play with Skid Row in Temecula, California, Pachanga Casino in November, and we're playing a couple shows with Cinderella. We're playing in Puerto Rico with Cinderella. We're playing at Silver Legacy Casino in Reno with Cinderella, and just on and on. So, and we're always booking.
This is taking me back, man.
Yeah, yeah. So we're going to Canada.
I'm definitely going to have to catch some of these shows.
Yeah, yeah. So check out the website. It's, you know, we're always adding more shows, and there's a lot of shows with different bands like Skid Row and Poison and Cinderella and Whitesnake. We're doing a big festival called Rock USA in Wisconsin. We're playing Friday night with Lynyrd Skynyrd and Journey. So I'm
very
excited about that. And so there's all kinds of stuff going on.
Well, all right. And before we wrap it up, is there anything else you want to throw out there?
Yeah, I just want to thank everybody that's checked out the new music and worked real hard of it, and we're proud of it, and we really appreciate the support that we've gotten at the live shows and for this new record. It's pretty exciting for us. So thank you for listening.
Absolutely. Well, thanks, Eric, for giving me a call. Best of luck to you guys with the new record.
Yeah, I really appreciate the support and taking the time to talk to me and talk about Warrant. So sweet song.